Hey guys, Evan here with Kirshy's Professional Services. Hey, listen, I know it took me a long time to do this, but I wanted to do an updated video on my pressure washing rig. Really simple. I've already kind of gone through how I routed everything here. As you can see, this is the rig put together. I have a 4,000 PSI. It's a 5 gallon per minute pressure pro. Runs a GSX. Or a GX390 Honda engine on it. Plenty of power, plenty of water volume for what I do, mostly residential, even for some commercial items as well too. I have a 65 gallon feed tank. I have all of my, small equipment that I put in the bucket here. Take this off so you can see. I have 150 foot of high pressure, rated up to 4,500 PSI. This is really all I need. If I need to extend, I can put an extra whip line on it at the end, which I carry back here, all my hoses. I leave this thing on the trailer. I never took it off the trailer, or I'm sorry, I left it on the cart, and I didn't mount it like some people do. And the reason for that is because, if I come across the instance where I do need to go a little bit further than what my high pressure hose can get me to, maybe a townhome community, I can remove the machine from the trailer if necessary and just feed it from somebody's garden hose directly. So what I did here was I have my right angle out of the tank at the bottom with a banjo connection, and it goes right into here. I do usually have a filter on here, but my filter broke, so I had to remove it and kind of just rig it up for temporarily. The filter I use is a high flow filter. I got it from Amazon for like $35. I can't remember exactly the name of the product, but once I get that information, I'll fill you guys in on that. So what typically happens is my high pressure hose will connect to here, or it'll get my inline. All right, so here I have my inline draw hose. This sits in my bucket. I just use a 5 gallon bucket. Put it right in, I mix my chemicals up in there, and this will draw with low pressure. I do a lot of low pressure wash just because I think that's a lot better for customers siding, and it's just easier to make sure the chemicals are doing its job as opposed to the pressure. I'll try to get this down in there for you.
I have a shutoff valve. That once the water gets up to that height, it will shut itself off.
All right, so as you guys can see, it's a pretty basic setup. If you have any other additional questions, just throw them in the comments box below. And please don't forget to subscribe and hit me with a like if you like the video. Thanks, guys.